I thought there might have been something along the back of it. The sight of such a friendly town fills you with determination. Well, let's see what's in the shop. Hello, traveler. How can I help? Is it a... Seems like a very shadowy shop. The background's brightly lit, but the character seems kind of dark. Maybe the light's all in the background. So is it a rabbit? I'm not entirely certain. Tough glove. Manly bandana. It has abs on it. Bicycle. Eat it twice. Cinnamon bun. Well, defense is probably a good thing. And some healing items wouldn't be a bad idea either. Hi, welcome to Snowden. I can't remember the last time I saw a fresh face around here. Where did you come from, the capital? You don't look like a tourist. Are you here by yourself? Maybe. You want to know what to do here in Snowden? Grillby's has food, and the library has information. If you're tired, you can take a nap at the inn. It's right next door. My sister runs it. And if you're bored, you can sit outside and watch those wacky skeletons do their thing. Oh, I've been doing plenty of that already. There's two of them. Brothers, I think. They showed up one day and asserted themselves. Time has gotten a lot more interesting since then. Think back to your history class. A long time ago, monsters lived in the ruins back there in the forest. Long story short, we all decided to leave the ruins and head for the end of the caverns. Along the way, some fuzzy folk decided they liked the cold and set up camp in Snowden. Oh, don't think about trying to explore the ruins. The door's been locked for ages, so unless you're a ghost who could burrow into the door, forget about it. Well, I kind of came from that way, so... maybe they're not supposed to know that, though. Life's same as usual, a little claustrophobic, but we all know deep down that freedom is coming, don't we? As long as we got that hope, we can grit our teeth and face the same struggles day after day. That's life, ain't it? Something about being free. Bye now, come again sometime. I might. We shall see. What's this? Mom says that sleeping can recover your health above your maximum HP. What's maximum HP? Welcome to Snowed In. The puns, they will never stop. Snowden's Premier Hotel, one night is 80 G. Deary me. I'm going to see what's outside first. Don't want to walk to the other side of town? Try the under-snow tunnels. They're efficiently laid out. Whoa! Alrighty then. It's locked from the inside. Well, I guess I'm not going in there then. It's locked. This mailbox is labeled Papyrus. Look inside? Sure, why not? It's empty. It's a mailbox overflowing with unread junk mail. Well then. Librarby. What? Welcome to the library. Yes, we know the sign is misspelled. Well then, it's too expensive to get it replaced. Now look in your eye. You're someone that has trouble doing crosswords, aren't you? Yeah, that's an oddly specific thing to know. I love working on the newspaper. There's so little to report that we just fill it with comics and games. Cough, cough. When I was younger, my teachers gave me word searches and they ran out of assignments. I thought they were a waste of time. But look at me now. I'm the number one word search creator in the entire underground. Love, hope, compassion. This is what people say monster souls are made of. The absolute nature of soul is unknown. All humans have proven their souls don't need these things to exist. Oh, I'm reading these backwards. Fearing the humans no longer root out of our old city home. Braved harsh, cold, damp swampland and searing heat. Till we reach what we now call our capital. New home. Again, our king is really bad at names. It's a school report about monster funerals. Monster funerals, technically speaking, are cool as heck. When monsters get old and kick the bucket, they turn into dust. At funerals, we take that dust and spread it on that person's favorite thing. So I'd be spread on an old Macintosh or something. Then their essence will live on in that thing. Am I at the page minimum yet? I'm kinda sick of writing this. Well then, kid putting minimum effort of report. While monsters are mostly made of magic, human beings are mostly made of water. Humans with their physical forms are far stronger than us, but they will never know the joy of expressing themselves through magic. They'll never get a bullet-patterned birthday card. Well, I'm sure I could make a bullet-patterned birthday card, but it would involve actual bullets. Take the birthday card, go to a shooting range. Here's your bullet-pattern card. That's a little odd. Well, yes, it is. Here I am, writing this book. A person comes in and picks up the book. They start reading it. Oh, sorry, I'm still writing that one. Because they are made of magic, monsters' bodies are attuned to their soul. If a monster doesn't want to fight, its defenses will weaken. The crueler the intentions of our enemies, the more their attacks will hurt us. Therefore, if a being with a powerful soul struck with a desire to kill, let's end the chapter here. Oh, dearie me. So it's all based on the intent? The cruelty? That sounds scary. We all know the underground has problems, but we smile anyway. Why? We can't do anything, so why be morose about it? Everyone is always laughing and cracking jokes, trying to forget our modern crises. Dreariness, crowding, lack of sunlight. I would join them, but I'm just not very funny. Big old bear outside? This town doesn't have a mayor. But if there's ever a problem, a skeleton will tell a fish lady about it. That's politics. Yeah, whatever you say. Yo, you're a kid too, right? I can tell because you're wearing a striped shirt.
What?
Okay then. Awful teens tormented the local monster by decorating its tree-like horns, so we started giving that monster presents to make it feel better. Now it's a tradition to put presents underneath a decorated tree. Well then, is my little cinnamon just the cutest? Bun buns are so adorable. Bun buns, huh? Bun 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 bun.
What?
That lady over there, something about her disturbs me. Maybe I should have a stay at the inn. Here's your room key. Make sure to bundle up. I could still move for a second there. There's a bunch of snoring bunnies over there, it seems. Hey, you look like you had a great sleep, which is incredible because you were only up there for about 2 minutes. Here's your money back. You can pay me if you're going to stay overnight. Well then. Well, since I get the money back, let's try something here. Because I could move for a little bit. A dialogue box showed up! And I'm sleeping face down this time. That snoring almost sounds like buzzsaws over there. Actually, it sounds kind of creepy. So the inns are basically free then. At least it seems like it. Yeah, let's check out Grillby's. That dude is on fire. I assume it's a monster thing. No matter where I go, it's the same menu, the same people. Help, I want new drinks and hot guys. Well, yeah, I suppose I'm not very hot, am I? Moving on. Besides, in this game I'm a child, so... Isn't human food different from monster food? It does things like spoil, and when you eat it, passes all the way through your whole body. Disgusting. I'd love to try it sometime. Well then. We're sentries, but we never get any respect. We're just those skeletons who throw us a bone. We love bones. You better watch where you sit down in here, kid. Because that big guy will jump into your lap and give you lots of love and attention. Yeah, I know, I... Are we playing poker over here? Can I join in? Thinking of getting a spiked collar to show off my personality. It makes a statement like, attach a leash to me and take me for a walk, please. I'm imagining this guy with a British Cockney accent now. His face goes all weird. I want to play poker with you guys, it looks like you're having fun. No, I guess a kid can't really gamble anyway. There's probably some law against... Or are they playing cards? It looks like poker chips and cards to me. Yo, what's up? Capital's getting pretty crowded, so I heard they're gonna start moving here. I don't want to see the erasure of our local culture, but I definitely want to see some city slickers slip onto their butts. The jukebox is broken, so it only plays the one song. Going to Grillby's, where everybody knows your name. These dogs are part of the Royal Guard, the elite military group led by Undyne. I keep hearing about this Undyne fellow. She's rude, loud, and beats up everybody who gets in her way. Well, in the infamous words of Spike Spiegel... What were the exact words? Love the kind of woman that can kick my ass. I think that was it. It's no wonder all the kids want to be like her when they grow up. I put out a line for some girls today. Someone told me there are plenty of fish in the sea. Well, I'm taking that seriously. I'm literally going to make out with a fish. I have no comment. It's playing poker against itself. It appears to be losing. How is that even possible? Can I play? No one wants to let me play. Grilbs said he'd offer you a glass of water, but he doesn't touch this stuff. Well, yes, I would like a glass. Well, yeah, of course he wouldn't touch water. Bah, I need a drink. Actually, I really do need a drink. Nothing to worry about. I think there's, like, a lot more room on this thing than I'm giving it credit for right now. Said I had enough room to record audio for 150 hours, and I'm recording some pretty, it's pretty efficient, the low-color codec. Let's play Monsters and Humans. You aren't gonna make me the human again, are you? Oh, to be young again. The world sure felt boundless. Ah, what a beautiful knock. Maybe if I don't answer, I'll hear it again. Ah, my patience rewards me. Damn it all. So that's where all the ice is coming from then. Well then. And this is water. I don't seem to be able to do anything there. Actually surprised I've got people talking in a chat on something I'm streaming. It's a very strange feeling to... Oh, God. What's going on? Oh, dearie me. Oh, dearie me! No, I think it's... Hey, that must be Papyrus. Human! Allow me to tell you about some complex feelings. Feelings like the joy of finding another pasta lover, the admiration for another's puzzle-solving skills, the desire to have a cool, smart person think you are cool. These feelings, they must be what you are feeling right now. I can hardly imagine what it must be like to feel that way. After all, I am very great. I don't ever wonder what having lots of friends is like. I pity you, lonely human. You don't have to rub it in. I already know I'm lonely. Worry not, you shall be lonely no longer. I, the great Papyrus, will be your... No. No, this is all wrong. I can't be your friend. You are a human. I must capture you. Then I can fulfill my lifelong dream. Powerful, popular, prestigious. That's Papyrus, the newest member of the Royal Guard. Oh, dearie me. HP 30 of 20. Eight attack, two defense. He likes to say, yeah. I could have figured that much out already. Papyrus is cackling. Well, then I'm just going to have to flirt with you. What? Flirting? So you finally reveal your ultimate feelings. Oh dearie me, he's taking it seriously. Well, I'm a skeleton with very high standards. I can't make spaghetti. Ah, I don't know, man. Oh no, that humility reminds me of myself. You're meeting all my standards. Let's date later. I'm trying to capture you. Well, you're going to be a very disappointed skeleton then. Papyrus is thinking about what to wear for his date. Oh, dearie me. So you won't fight. Then, let's see if you can handle my fabled blue attack. Wait, really? It doesn't really work if you use all blue, Papyrus. But that... dearie me. You're blue now! That's my attack. Well played, Papyrus. Well played. Yeah. You're blue now. I wonder what I should wear. Woo! I can jump pretty high. That's good. I just dab some bone cologne behind his ear. What? I'm not thinking about that date thing. A date with a skeleton. How very bizarre. Ow, damn. Dabs marinara sauce behind his ear. What's gonna eat mozzarella sticks with? I wouldn't put it behind my ears. Hold up longer to jump higher. Jeez, I knew that. I just screwed up a little is all. He's telling me how to dodge his attacks. How very odd. I thought he wanted to capture me. He has MTT brand Bishy cream behind his... I don't know if he wants to be a Bishy. It's... Yeah, don't make me use my special attack! Yeah, it's the... You've got a child and the skeleton with the mind of a child. Yeah, they said that the inns restore your HP beyond its maximum. I talked to that little bunny kid and he told me this. I can almost taste my future popularity. That's what I used to think of. Oh, wait, no, I never thought that. Oh, I need to stop being distracted by my talking. The Pyrus, head of the royal guard. Well, he's continuing to say different things, so I assume MTT brand attraction slime behind it. What kind of products do they sell in the underground? Pyrus, unparalleled spaghettor. Spaghetti? Oh, damn. Beauty yogurt? I really don't want to know what kind of shop sells all this nonsense. Undyne will be really proud of me. Give me the Undyne thing. Hey! Oh god! Jumping like Shaquille O'Neal over here. The Pyrus realizes he doesn't have ears. The king will trim a hedge in the shape of my smile. Oh god. Old. Okay, I just jump in place. And Pyrus is preparing a bone attack. No, really. Insult. Pyrus is too busy fighting to accept your insult. My brother will. Well, he won't change very much. Damn! Pyrus is preparing a bone at. Yes, I know that. I have lots of admirers, but. But what? Tell me your problems, Papyrus. I'm listening. Ah, bollocks! Pyrus whispers, "Nyeh-heh-heh. Anyone like me as sincerely as you." God! Dad! You're too weak. I was easily able to capture you. I'll now send you to the capture zone. Or Sans call us a garage. You're in the doghouse now. Nyeh-ha-ha-ha-ha. Oh dearie me, another one of these gates. Well, okay. Well, I didn't lose on purpose to Papyrus. That's the embarrassing part. It's a note from Papyrus. Sorry, I have to lock you in the guest room until Undyne arrives. Feel free to make yourself at home. Refreshments and accommodations have been provided. Nearly yours, Papyrus. Unfortunately, it's just dry food. It's a squeaky chew toy. It's too small to sleep on. It's a shame. I needed to recover my HP. Actually, it might just be full now. So that's the garage, then. That was kind of embarrassing, but I didn't die. Papyrus is kind of silly about, like, actually capturing me. Well, I do know that I'm not going to, like, die if I lose to him, so why not? Wait, it's right in front of me. Hello, I was worried that you had gotten lost. It sure is a relief to know you're right here. Wait a second, you're not supposed to escape. Get back there! Papyrus blocks the way. Again. He likes to say. Yes, I figured that much out. And I'm still blue! What? I'm not thinking of that date thing. Right, and I'm not thinking of ways to be silly. Wow, Papyrus has a really long mercy invincibility. That makes sense. He's trying to tell me, dude, what are you doing? You're being stupid. Well, you may have cleverly escaped from jail before, but this time, I've upgraded the facilities. Not only will you be trapped, but you won't even want to leave! Yeah. a note from Papyrus. Please ask before you escape. When you went missing, I got worried sick. Slightly bone-trousled Papyrus. There's a hot dog cut up into the kibble. They really don't know much about humans, do they? I suppose it makes sense. Well, I'm just gonna slip through the bars of the garage again. You know, if they owned a dog, that dog would be able to run away. Oh dear. Hello again. Back again, eh? I suppose it's my fault. I told you before I would make you spaghetti. It's only natural you would want to see me, and the dire hope I would make you some. Well, I understand. Papyrus is hungry too. Hungry for justice? I always pronounce justice that way. When I'm doing an over-the-top voice. It's silly. I'm a silly person. I just stay here. He's probably going to wonder what in the world. I was still flashing with the Mercy invincibility. We can jump on top of your bones and see how you like that. I think this is a platformer now. You are persistent, but it just won't work on me. I am the persistentest, and if you think you are persistentest-er... You sound like the difficulty levels in Super Hexagon. That is wrong! Grammatically wrong! Because the correct form would be not as persistentest as Papyrus the persistentestestest. Good lord. It's the difficulty levels in Super Hexagon. Hardestest-er. Hardestestest. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Yeah. Well, I guess I just got schooled by Papyrus. It's a note from Papyrus. If you're just looking for a place to stay, just ask. You don't need to fight me. Your host, Papyrus. Here's a hot dog cut up into the kibble. It's too small to sleep on. Yes, yes. Well, I think it's probably time we actually try and actually, you know, beat him or something. That would probably be a good thing to do. If we actually want to get past this game at some point in the near future. Sorry then, we may have exhausted our possibilities. You're back again? Oh, I finally realized the true reason why. You just miss seeing my face so much. I'm not sure I can fight someone who feels this way, but mostly, I'm getting really tired of capturing you. Oh dearie me, I think my stream went out. Yeah, slight connection issues. Sorry about that. Fight Papyrus? No! Okay, I guess I'll accept my failure. Wait, what? No! Yoo-hoo-hoo, I can't even stop someone as weak as you. Dad's gonna be disappointed to be. I'll never join the Royal Guard, and my friend quantity will remain stagnant. Really? You want to be friends with me? Well then, I guess I could make an allowance for you. Wowie, we haven't even had our first date. I've already managed to hit the friends. If only I knew what that was like. Who knew that all I needed to make pals was to give people awful puzzles and then fight them? You taught me a lot, human. I'm not sure that's the lesson you should take away from this. I hereby grant you permission to pass through, and I'll give you directions to the surface. Continue forward until you reach the end of the cavern. Then, when you reach the capital, cross the barrier. That's the magical seal trapping us all underground. Anything can enter through it, but nothing can exit, except someone with a powerful soul, like you. That's why the king wants to acquire a human. He wants to open the barrier with soul power. Then us monsters can return to the surface. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you. To reach the exit, you will have to pass through the king's castle. The king of all monsters. King of monsters? He's a big fuzzy pushover. Everybody loves that guy. So then if you just say, "Excuse me, Mr. Dreamer, can I please go home?" He'll guide you right to the barrier himself. Anyway, that's enough talking. I'll be at home being a cool friend. Feel free to come by and have that date. Well, I expected what if I said no. He might have still tried to fight me anyways, but... Oh dear, don't start making the mirror puns. We don't need those. Definitely don't need those. Man, gyms! Man, if this was Minecraft, I'd be picking away like crazy. But this isn't Minecraft, because... Yeah... What is over this way? Where's... Save point, that's probably a good thing. Sneaking out to see her too? Awesome, she's the coolest, right? I'm just like her when I grow up. Hey, don't tell my parents I'm here. This is an echo flower. It repeats the last thing it heard over and over. Neat, huh? Oh dear. What? Haven't you seen a guy with two jobs before? Fortunately, two jobs means twice as many legally required breaks. I'm going to Grillby's. Wanna come? Sure. Well, if you insist, I'll pry myself away from my work. Over here. I know a shortcut. So Papyrus Sands knows all the... How come I keep... I guess it's because I've been dealing with Papyrus for so long. That shortcut, huh? Hey, everyone. Hey, Sands. Hi, Sands. Greetings, Sands. Hiya, Sands, hey. Hey, Sands, weren't you just here for breakfast a few minutes ago? Nah, I haven't had breakfast in at least half an hour. You must be thinking of brunch. Oh, dearie me. Yeah, get comfy. Whoops, watch where you sit down. Sometimes weirdos put whoopee cushions on the seats. Anyway, let's order what you want. I'm thinking just fries. Hey, that sounds pretty good. Really, I love a double order of fries. So, what do you think? My brother. He's cool, I guess. Of course he's cool. He'd be cool too if he wore that outfit every day. I don't know, I think I'd stink. A lot. Unless I washed it every day, but that seems like a lot of effort. You'd only take that thing off if he absolutely had to. Oh well, at least he washes. Oh, thank goodness. Wait, skeletons wouldn't... And by that I mean he wears it in the shower. Skeletons wouldn't stink. Never mind, I don't know how monsters work. Here comes the grub. Want some ketchup? Another fun fact about me if you're watching this stream. I don't like ketchup very much. More for me. He just drank the entire bottle of ketchup. Gross. Cool or not, you have to agree Papyrus tries real hard. He keeps trying to be part of the Royal Guard. One day, he went to the house of the head of the Royal Guard and begged her to let him be in it. Of course, she shut the door on him because it was midnight. But the next day, she woke up and saw him still waiting there. Seeing his dedication, she decided to give him warrior training. It's still a work in progress. Oh yeah, wanted to ask you something. Whoa. You ever heard of a talking flower? Whoa. Well, I don't think Sans has a stomach lining, so... Yeah. Anyway, yes. So you know all about it. The Echo Flower. They're all over the marsh. Oh. God. Say something to them and they'll repeat it over and over. What about it? Well, Papyrus told me something interesting the other day. Sometimes when no one else is around, the flower appears and whispers things to him. Flattery, advice, encouragement, predictions. Weird, huh? Someone must be using an echo flower to play a trick on him. Keep an eye out, okay? Thanks. That's not the flower I was thinking of, but... I saw a Guinness World Record thing where somebody drank a bottle of ketchup in like... Was it 8 or 12 seconds? Or some ridiculous amount of time. And I just gagged. That was a long break. Can't believe I let you pull me away from work for that long. Oh, by the way, flat broke. You foot the bill? It's just 10,000 G. What's... No. Just kidding. Groovy, put it on my tab. I don't have 10,000 G. By the way, I was going to say something, but I forgot. Good to know. Oh, the fries are still there. I guess we were so busy talking. It's a shame, I'm hungry. You know, I guess I may as well sleep at the inn real quick. Because I need that overcharge. I keep seeing a dialogue box pop up when I try and talk to them again when the transition is happening, but... there's no text or anything. Okay. Apparently this guy takes power naps. That's what it is, it's power naps. He just sleeps for 2 minutes and suddenly... Which makes me wonder what would happen if you slept for hours on end. Would you gain, like, Uber... I'm not gonna use the term Uber charge, but... Hey, that papyrus. So you came back to have a date with me! You must be really serious about this. I'll have to take you someplace really special. A place I like to spend a lot of time. Where would that be? Don't tell me. Where are you going? My house! Well, I guess I needed the exercise anyway. What in the world? That doesn't look safe. It looks like there's a flaming rave party going on under the door, and that sounded really bad out of context. No flaming rave parties. I mean, like, literally on fire, not... You know what I mean. Dirty sock with a series of notes on it. Sans, please pick up your sock. Okay. Don't put it back down. Move it. Okay. You moved it 2 inches. Move it to your room. Okay. And don't bring it back. Okay. It's still here. Didn't you just say not to bring it back to my room? Forget it. Oh my. Ooh, it's my favorite game show! It says, stay tuned for a new program, MTT. What? It's usually better than this. This is just a bad episode, don't judge me. You mean the color bars on the TV? It's a joke book. Take a look inside. Why not? Inside the joke book was a quantum physics book. Oh god, don't make me do quantum physics again. You look inside. Inside the quantum physics book was another joke book. You look inside. There's another quantum physics book. Oh, God. You decide to stop. Yeah, we're going to run into Schrodinger's book, where it only exists based on the state of our observation. Welcome to Scenic My House. Enjoy and take your time. Touch the couch. It makes a jangling sound. Find a bunch of loose coins inside the couch. You got 20 G... Jeez. That's my room! If you finished looking around, you could go in and do whatever people do when they date? Not yet. I'm still looking around. What do you think people do when they date? A classic image. It always reminds me of what's important in life. Bones? Isn't there a TV show called Bones? Yeah, there was. I've watched some of it. Interesting. The door is locked. Yeah, because it looks like a portal to epilepsy hell in there. I'd probably get a seizure if I went in there. This is my brother's pet rock. He always forgets to feed it. He As usual, I have to take responsibility. The rock is covered in sprinkles. My brother always goes out to eat, but recently he tried baking something. It's like a quiche. It filled with a sugary non-egg substance. How absurd. So, a pastry? You impressed? I increased the height of my sink. Now I can fit more bones under it. Take a look-see. What? Catch that meddling canine! If it wasn't for you meddling kids... Curses! Sans! Stop plaguing my life with incidental music! Aha! Interested in my food museum? A food museum? Please peruse my culinary art show! Half of the fridge is filled with containers all labeled as spaghetti. The other half contains nothing but an empty bag of chips. Well then, that's the trash can! Feel free to visit it anytime! Okay then. Food museum. That's what I'm gonna call my fridge from now on. Food museum. That's my room! We've finished looking around, going and do whatever people do when they date. I mean, surf the internet randomly? Actually, that's a terrible idea. Let's not do that. Hey, those are all the attacks I used on you. Great memories, huh? Seems like it was only yesterday, even though it basically just happened. That looks like an old brick of a computer. The internet! I'm quite popular there. I'm just a dozen away from a double-digit follower count. Either you don't know what a dozen is, or you somehow have -2 followers. I'm not even going to ask. You apparently have a really glitchy version of whatever social network you're using. Of course, fame has a steep price. A jealous troll has besieged my online persona, always sending me bad puns in a goofy font. How dearie me. So Sans is trolling you. The computer's internet browser is open to a social media site. Could have guessed as much. There are no skeletons inside my closet. Except me, sometimes. Oh, clothes are hung up neatly inside, and yet all he wears is that. Maybe it's all battle armor. It's their bras. It's battle-ready armor. Kids Next Door reference, everyone. That book's one of my favorites. Advanced Puzzle Construction for Critical Minds. That next book's another one of my favorites. Peekaboo with Fluffy Bunny. The ending always gets me. Advanced Puzzle Construction. Ah, yes, action figures. A great reference for theoretical battle scenarios. So, Dungeons and Dragons? Car Wars? I would love to play some tabletop games, I never get to do that. So, how do I have so many? Well, let's just say they're from the chubby, smiling man who loves to surprise people. Yeah, that's right, Santa! Isn't that flag neato? Undyne found it at the bay. I think it's from the human world? Now, I know what you're thinking. Why would a human flag have a cool skeleton on it? Well, I have a theory. I think humans must have descended from skeletons. That's an interesting theory you've got going there, Papyrus. I labeled it Undertale. I put the proper label on the game and everything. I don't know why it wouldn't be showing up. That's my bed. If I ever get to the surface, I'd like to drive down a long highway. Wind in my hair, sun on my skin. Of course, that's just a dream. So instead I cruise while I snooze. So basically you want to play a game of Outrun. That can be arranged. So, if you've seen everything, do you want to start the date? Begin the date? Yes, okay then. Okay, dating start. Oh dearie. Dating start. Dun-dun-dun. Oh great. I don't know anything about dating. Ah! Here we are on a date. I've actually never done this. Well, join the club. But don't worry. You can't spell prepared without several letters for my name. snagged an official dating rulebook from the life. I could use that. Give it to me here. Ready to have a great time. Let's see. Step 1. Press the C key on your keyboard for dating HUD. Wowie, I feel so informed. I think we're ready for step... What's the annoying dog doing on the radar? Step 2. Ask them on a date. Ahem. Human, I, the great papyrus, will go on a date with you. That's not really a question. And why is the population fluctuating so wildly? Really? Wowie! I guess that means it's time for part 3. Step 3. Put on nice clothes to show you care. Wait a second. Wear clothing. A bandage hanging off of you. Wearing clothing right now. Not only that, earlier today you were also wearing clothing. No, could it be? You wanted to date me from the very beginning. Sure, why not? Oh god, I think I scored a critical hit. No, you planned it all. You're way better at dating than I am. No, you're dating power. Yeah. Don't think you've bested me yet. Hi, the great... Oh, that dramatic music. Ah, another new person in the chat. I've never been beaten at dating, and I never... You think dating is a competition? I thought you said you'd never dated before. Well, wait, that would mean you're undefeated. I can easily keep up with you. You see, I too can wear clothing. In fact, I always wear my special clothes underneath my regular clothes, just in case somebody happens to ask me on a date. Behold! Yeah, what do you think of my secret style? Oh, it's unique, I'll give it that. No! A genuine compliment! However, you don't truly understand the hidden power of this outfit. Therefore, what you just said is invalid. This date won't escalate any further. It's starting to sound like 8-bit music from Phoenix Wright or something. Unless you find my secret, but that won't happen. I understand why you're running away. You're overwhelmed by the sight of my cool vibes, but you can't back down now. I shouldn't originally say cool, but I improved it. Expert tip, all clothing articles can be improved this way. I see. Like caressing my biceps with a floating heart. But who doesn't? My hat? Yeah! Well then, you found my secret. I suppose I have no choice. It's a present. A present just for you. Do you know what this is? Hopefully not your brains. No idea. Yeah, that's right. You have no idea. This appears to be spaghetti. This ain't any plain old pasta. This is an artisan's work. Silken spaghetti, finely aged in an oaken cask. I don't think you're supposed to finely age spaghetti, dude. And cooked by me, Master Chef Papyrus. Human, it's time to end this. There's no way this can go any farther. Take a small bite. Your face reflexively scrunches up. The taste is indescribable. What a passionate expression. You must really love my cooking. By extension, me. Maybe even more than I do. Oh dear, I broke the date power meter. Human, it's clear now. You're madly in love with me. Everything you do, everything you say, it's all been for my sake. Human, I want you to be happy too. It's time for me to express my feelings. It's time that I told you. Boy, is it hot in here, or is it just me? Oh, shoot. Human, I'm sorry. I don't like you the way you like me. Romantically, I mean. I mean, I tried very hard to. Thought that because you flirted with me, that I was supposed to go on a date with you. Then, on the date, feelings would blossom forth. I'd be able to match your passion for me. But alas, I, the great Papyrus, have failed. I feel just the same as before. Instead, by dating you, I've only drawn you deeper into your intense love for me. Dark prison of passion with no escape. How could I have done this to my dear friend? No, wait, that's wrong. I can't fail at anything. Human, I'll help you through these trying times. I'll keep being your cool friend, and act like this all never happened. After all, you are very great. It'd be tragic to lose your friendship. So please, don't cry because I won't kiss you, because I don't even have lips. Valid point. And hey, someday you'll find someone as great as me. Well, no, that's not true. But I'll help you settle for second best. Good heavens. Well, I think I just got friend-zoned. I don't know what just happened, though. If you ever need to reach me, here's my phone number. You can call me anytime, platonically. Well, gotta go. Well, that just happened. Weird. Still wonder what in the world Sansa's room could possibly look like. Fire arts are not fine wines. Computers can be. Sort of. If you... well... all depends. Some people have to have the latest and greatest. I know people who... a person who collects some pretty old firearms, but... yeah. I don't really know very much about them. It's not really my area of expertise. All I've got is a prop Jericho 941. And that's because... I know what it's quoting. I do know that much. Surprisingly enough. Let's hang out again sometime. That sounds good to me. Oh dearie me, falling rocks. I think. This is a box. Oh, yes. Why would you, though? You can't use items when they're in the box. Sincerely, a box hater. Oh dear. Okay. Swore I saw something behind that rushing water. I thought I could mess with it by skipping through dialogue or something. I can't seem to go... well, unless I can go behind the rushing water in some other way, but... or I hit X. Huh? There's a camera behind the waterfall. There's cameras? I'm kind of scared now. Well, that was easier than I expected. Let's go up here. Oh, there is something. Deary me. There's a tutu lying on the ground here. Okay. Oh. What? Well, I suppose I'll have to put some things away. Store it in the box. I like all my healing items. There's a tutu lying on the ground here. Will you take it? Yes. I assume this has something to do with that other room. Maybe. I don't know. Because there were mushrooms there too, so... store that. Actually, I was going to look at it first. Armor defense 10. Finally, a protective piece of... An old tutu is a protective piece of armor. If you say so, I'm going to keep my healing items. And it's all dark and shadowy in here. Hi, Undyne. I'm here with my daily report regarding that human I called you about earlier. Huh? Did I fight them? Yes, of course I did. I fought them valiantly. What? Did I capture them? Well, no. I tried very hard, Undyne, but in the end, I failed. What? You're going to take the human soul yourself? But Undyne, you don't have to destroy them. You see... I understand. Help you in any way I can. Oh, dearie me. I'm not here! Did you see the way she was staring at you? That was awesome! I'm so jealous! What'd you do to get her attention? Ha! Come on, let's go watch her beat up some bad guys. Oh! Ow, ow. Woo! Okay, he's fine. So excited about that.
Feeling of dread hangs over you, but you stay determined.
When four bridge seeds align in the water, they will sprout. Okay. Good to know. So I've just got to collect these and throw them across the water then. Just checking that there's not anything hiding back there. Or in that crack in the wall either. Alright then. Okay, apparently we've run into a horse naga. flex more muscles. Attack increases for you too. Flexing contest? Okay, flex. I didn't want to increase anyone's attack. Shiznit! Seahorse has a lot of HP, horsepower. All of his attacks are harder to dodge at the bottom of the box. Check all you want, dear. I assume I'm supposed to keep flexing? And flexes thrice as hard, dear. No, don't get your freaking freaky muscles away from me. Squeaking? Did I squeak? I must have. You will flex. You mean the squeaking earlier. He flexes himself out of the room. That's impressive in a very odd sort of way. You won. That sign, how am I supposed to bloody read it? Or mushrooms. Lots of mushrooms, in fact. Oh, if an error is made, the bell blossom can call bridge seeds back to where they started. Well, I know what I can do to read the sign then. Let's see what it says. because we might as well. This game seems half about the journey anyway. Well, probably mostly, really. Congratulations! You failed the puzzle! Screw you! the signs are just mocking me now. Okay. Now, how get across this thing? Let's see. I need a four in a row somewhere. But I don't really see any. Unless they don't have to align all in a row? They probably do, though, so... this probably isn't going to work. Yeah. Okay. Gotta think a little more cleverly than that. Oh! I've got it! I think this little alcove is here. Oh, that's squeaking when I pick up the... I don't think my voice can go that high-pitched. Hello! This is Papyrus! How did I get this number? It was easy! I just dialed every number sequentially until I... So he war-dialed my number. Aw, are you making fun of me? That's not very nice. It's almost 6 in the morning. So what are you wearing? I'm asking for a friend. She thought she saw you wearing a gross bandage. Is that true? Are you wearing a gross bandage? Yes. So you are wearing a gross bandage. Got it. Wink wink. Have a nice day. I wonder. Still nobody's picking up. I suppose... this puzzle. I've got it. Try to build a bridge at the bridge sea. Thanks, already did that. Two answers. What did you do then? I'm not entirely sure I see another solution. I guess I do. If you were to go clear down here and throw the seeds from here, that could work too. Yeah, I suppose it would. Huh. That's clever. Long time ago, monsters would whisper their wishes to the stars in the sky. They hoped with all your heart that your wish would come true. Now, all we have are these sparkling stones on the ceiling. Wishing room. Thousands of people wishing together can't be wrong. The king will prove that. Washua shuffles up. Going to poke you. Washua recoils from your touch. Yuck. Oh dear! Spouting things in circles. Washua wonders if tears are sanitary. Clean? Hops around excitedly. Green means clean. It's not throwing any of them my way. Healed me. Whoa. Come on, sis, make a wish. I wish my sister and I will see the real stars someday. Oh boy. Look through the telescope. What? Check wall. Seems my horoscope is the same as last week's. Like this wall. Says to check a wall. And it pointed upwards? Or maybe I'm going straight up from here. Or it's straight forward from here. Maybe not. Okay. Let us go this way then. No. I could have figured that out on accident. Ancient writing covers the walls. You can just make out the words. The war of humans and monsters. Why did the humans attack? Indeed, it seems that they had nothing to fear. Humans are unbelievably strong. It would take the soul of nearly every monster just to equal the power of a single human soul. But humans have one weakness. Ironically, it is the strength of their soul. Its power allows it to persist outside the human body, even after death. Oh dear, we're getting crazy soul things happening here. If a monster defeats a human, they can take its soul. A monster of the human soul, a horrible beast with unfathomable power. It's an illustration of a strange creature. There's something very unsettling about this drawing. I guess I'll just have to imagine it for myself. I've seen plenty of unsettling things on the internet. Although I don't think that's quite what they mean by unsettling. Nope, it's a raft. Kind of looks like wooden planks from Minecraft. I'm going to stop making Minecraft references now. This is not that kind of channel. I'm not going to sit around playing freaking Minecraft. Ah! Oh, bollocks! Oh, holy balls! No, nope. I'm gonna dodge things on the overworld too. I'm going to throw you off! Haha! Aha! You will not counteract my incredible powers. I've played Spectre. I know how to dodge leading. Shit! No, I don't. They are definitely trying to kill me. Good lordy! Hide in the grass! That didn't work! Oh, did it? Maybe it did. Oh, God. That kind of looked like it hurt. Like, a lot. Are you okay? Where'd you go, monster kid? You didn't look very okay. Yo, did you see that? Undyne just touched me! I'm never washing my face ever again! Man, are you unlucky. If you were standing just a little bit to the left. Yo, don't worry. I'm sure I'll see her again. Yeah, she probably would have crushed my face. I don't think I'd have been okay with that. Squeak. Well then. This cheese has been here so long, a magical crystal has grown around it. It's stuck to the table. Because of course it is. Knowing the mouse might one day extract the cheese from the mystical crystal. It fills you with determination. Oh, hi, Sans. Old Sansy, old buddy, old pal. It's an odd-looking telescope. Thinking about getting into the telescope business. It's normally 50,000 G to use this premium telescope, but since I know you, you can use it for free. How's about it? I bet I'm going to get one of those eye circle things. It's like nothing. That's what I thought. Huh? You aren't satisfied. Don't worry, I'm gonna give you a full refund. Ha! What's a star? Can you touch it? Can you eat it? Can you kill it? Are you a star? I'm only mildly internet famous. I wouldn't call myself a star so much. It's all very pretty looking. I wonder what's in here. Oh, hey, it's an ice cream man again. Relocated my store, but there's still no customers. Fortunately, I've thought of a solution. Punch cards! Every time you buy an ice cream, you can take a punch card from the box. If you have 3 cards, you could trade them for a free ice cream. They're sure to get the customers to come back. I might buy one because I kind of got hurt by all the spears. Is this as sweet as you? Your HP is maxed out. The ancient glyphs have been painted over with a list of 21 different Dude, you wrecked the ancient glyphs! What have you done? You rabbity blue history destroying archive hating bastard! How dare you do such things? Is there anything in that other direction? So, don't you have any wishes to make? Just one, but it's kind of stupid. What is that other direction? I spare you immediately! Nah. Do you think this game's even going to be rated by the ESRB? Well then, I guess I'm going the other way then. Deary me. Yeah, So the heart sprouts little tiny legs and that just happened. Pair of ballet shoes. Alrighty then. Ballet shoes. Weapon. These used shoes make you feel incredibly dangerous. One of the Darkwing Duck own a pair of ballet shoes at one point. Let's get dangerous. This is Papyrus. Remember when I asked you about clothes? Well, a friend who wanted to know. Your opinion of you is very murdery. But I bet you knew that already. Because you knew that. I told him what you told me you were wearing. A gross bandage. Because I knew, of course. It was such a suspicious question. You would obviously change your clothes. You're such a smart cookie. Swear you're safe and I didn't lie. No betrayal anywhere. Being friends with everyone is easy.
Sure is, Papyrus. It sure is. Damn it.
This seems incredibly dangerous for me to be doing, actually. Oh well, I get mummies. Because that's how sparing people works, you get money for it. You're a passing conversation. Don't say that. Come on, I promise I won't laugh. Did they have these conversations as they were walking through the place? Power to take their souls. This is the power the humans feared. Yeah, I suppose. Oh god. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh no, wait. Mom? Hey there. Noticed you were here. I'm Onion-san, you here? You're visiting Waterfall, huh? It's great here, huh? You love it, huh? Yeah, me too. It's my big favorite. What is with this thing? It's creeping me out. Even though the water's getting so shallow here, I have to sit down all the time, but... Hey, that's okay. Beats moving to the city. I'm living in a crowded aquarium, like all my friends did. The aquarium's full anyway, so... But if I wanted to, I... That's okay, though, you hear? Then Dan's gonna fix everything, you hear? I'm gonna get out of here and live in the ocean, you hear? Yes, I hear you. I hear you loud and clear. Hey, there. That's the end of this room. I'll see you around. Have a good time. In Waterfall... Didn't I read a comic sort of like that just recently, except it involved a shark? Something like that. Shiren hides in the corner, but somehow encounters you anyway. Tone deaf. She's too ashamed to sing a deadly song. Hum hum. Wave your arms wildly. You are now vulnerable to electric attacks. What? It's quieter. In the corner, Aaron nods his head. What? Is Aaron hiding out in the corner somewhere? I know who showed it to me. Hum a jazz ballad. Shiren follows your melody. -150 defense. I wonder. Suddenly it's a concert. What? Sansa's selling tickets made of toilet paper. Well then. You hum some more. The seats are sold out. You feel like a rock star. Oh dear, eh? It's kind of starting to look like a Rhythm Heaven game. Crowd tosses clothing. It's a storm of socks. Comes from all the constant attention, the tours, the groupies. It's all aggressive. Each Shiren have come so far, but it's time. You both have your own journeys to embark on. You hum a farewell song. Oh, jeez! My goodness gracious me! Well, alright then. Fun. Apparently we lived the life of a rock star for in the brief space of a few minutes. Northern room hides a great treasure. It's a piano. Okay, I'm done here. I don't know. I'll probably have to figure it out later. This power has no counter. Instead, a human cannot take a monster's soul. Or indeed. When a soul monster dies, its soul disappears, and an incredible power would be needed to take the soul of a living monster. Yeah, boy. This is all getting kind of crazy. There is only one exception, the soul of a special species of monster called a boss monster. Strong enough to persist after death, if only for a few moments. A human could absorb this soul, but this has never happened. And now it never will. It's a statue. The structures at its feet seem dry. Please take one. An umbrella. Yeah, this is nice. Yo, you got an umbrella? Awesome! Well, they were right there. You could have taken one too. Let's go. You're kind of supposed to walk like right beside me if you want to actually stay dry. Man, that dine is so cool. She beats up bad guys and never loses. If I was a human, I'd wet the bed every night. Though she was gonna beat me up. Ha! Alrighty then. If you say so. I mean. Yeah. So, one time, we had a school project where we had to take care of a flower. King. We had to call him Mr. Dreamer, volunteered to donate his own flowers. He ended up coming to school and teaching the class about responsibility and stuff. That got me thinking, yo, how cool would it be if Undyne came to school? Oh, that sounds like a... She could beat up all the teachers. That sounds like a terrible idea. That sounds violent. You seem kind of violent, Monster Kid. Maybe she wouldn't beat up the teachers. Too cold to ever hurt an innocent person. If you say so. Oh, I'm still in control here. Little castle and stars, maybe.